Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is BestInSlot, and we are back playing Telltale Games Game of Thrones.
Two White Hill soldiers?
And a Bolton.
They killed my family. And for what?
My sister, she was only 8 years old.
This never would have happened with the Starks in power. It's unimaginable. Unacceptable. You have my condolences.
Thank you, Maester.
The blade cut deep, but I should be able to save your leg. Your justice was swift. Some will call it vengeance. No doubt the Whitehills will claim it was murder. It was your family. I can't say I would have done any different than you.
I'd do it again if I had the chance.
If we don't respond with strength, they won't stop until they have everything. These maggots ought to help prevent infection. Hold the wound open for me, would you?
Oh. This doesn't even make sense. There's no dead flesh yet. Why would I need maggots? Come on, Game of Thrones. Ew. Why?
These are dark days, I fear. To lose the Lord of the House and the eldest son through such a despicable act of treachery and betrayal. Greater houses than ours have fallen in times such as this. The late Lord Forrester was a good man. And poor Roderick. A serious man, but he would have made a good lord.
Well, what do we do now?
The future of this house is in Lord Ethan's hands now. Although he is young. And altogether unprepared to lead.
I'll do it.
Right. This might hurt a bit. Hold this for me, will you? I understand from your uncle that Lord Forrester saved your life.
He did.
Rather odd, though, that he chose to save you, his squire, and not his son, Roderick. Not that Roderick couldn't handle himself. He was as good with a sword as any man I've seen.
Roderick had already fallen. There was nothing we could do.
Well, then I'd imagine Lord Forrester would sacrifice himself to save anyone from his house, high or low. Lady Forrester will be here any moment now. I'd like you to walk for me first, to see if you can put any weight on that leg.
I'm not convinced. All those maggots will be bloody weighing me down, I tell you.
Go on. Don't stop now. It's better to let the blood circulate.
Okay. Okay, can I talk to you again? I want to touch the bucket.
Rather cute little creatures, aren't they?
No.
Yes.
No, they are not. Why are doctors always crazy people? Seriously. Okay, what's this over here?
This might help.
Stocking up. I'm just stealing his things, really, aren't I? That's all that's happening here. Anyways, thank you. Can I steal the tapestry as well?
You seem to be favoring it. Always sad to see a warrior lose a leg.
Quite now, I'm looking at a painting.
Mirror. Still in King's Landing, I suppose. Although, I wonder if they'll bring her home.
She's probably dead now, buddy.
Talia and Ethan. I suppose Lord Ethan now. Asher. Exiled to Essos, unfortunately.
Wonder why.
Lady Forrester. She's always been kind to me. Treated me like I was a forester myself. Ryan. Never easy being a fourth-born son.
I wonder who he's talking to right now.
Lord Forrester. It was an honor to squire for him. Gregor the Good. Roderick. He was our best warrior by far.
Aww. Learn more about the Foresters from the menu codex page.
I may be mistaken. You do seem able to put weight on it.
not a bad chair, as chairs go. I'd sit on it. I'd sit on that chair. Well done, chair. Look at window. God, they do give you exciting things to look at, don't they?
The Ironwood Grove.
Okay. See, I'm fine, even with all the bloody maggots. Quite literally at this point in time, bloody maggots. I'm okie dokie, maester. You're not going to take my leg, alright? I'm going to keep it. You're not having my sword either. It's mine.
Did your leg feel weak?
No. I just wanted to ask you. Who is the new lord of House Forrester?
Why, Ethan, of course. At the Citadel, I swore an oath to serve whichever noble house I was assigned. Advising the late Lord Forrester was an honor. Advising Ethan, his third-born son, is challenging. There's still so much he has to learn, yet the very fate and future of this house rests in his hands. Which is rather frightening when you think about it.
Bloody terrifying, my friend. Bloody terrifying.
Can I go now?
I believe your leg will be fine. Only time will tell, but... Lady Forrester.
Welcome home, Garrett. We're all relieved to know you survived.
Thank you, my lady.
Talia asked to see you.
Garrett, I heard what happened. Is it true? Your family...
Aww.
I'm so sorry.
It's okay.
Mato.
Off to bed now. Hurry on.
Garrett was just telling me how valiantly Lord Forrester fought to the end, even when all was lost. I'm sure Lady Forrester would like to know.
That's a complete lie.
Whatever you can recall.
He loved his family, my lady. He was very proud of Roderick.
Yet he was unable to save him.
You were with Roderick, no? I'm sure it was chaos and confusion, but if you can remember anything...
He fought valiantly, my lady.
Of course he did. He was House Forrester's best.
This has been so incredibly difficult for us, especially the children. But I was told... I was told you were the last to see my husband alive.
Yes, my lady.
I know it may be difficult to remember, but if I may ask... Was there anything he said?
Any last words before he passed? If you can remember. It would mean so much to the family.
He said he loved you.
That's very kind of you to say. You have the Forrester sword.
Ethan should have it, now that he is Lord.
Lord Forrester asked me to return it to the house. He said this is where it belongs. With his family.
Thank you, Garrett.
Of course, my lady.
It demands a response.
It's too dangerous, especially now.
Now is the time to prove our strength.
I'll be sure it's given to Ethan.
Aww. Give me my sword back.
Duncan, this was our land. They were our people. Your family.
I share your outrage, Sir Roiland. I do. But now is not the time to provoke the White Hills. Not with Ramsay Snow coming to see us bend the knee.
The hell with Ramsay Snow, the bastard.
Garrett, you understand what this means. You killed a Bolton, and Ramsay Snow will want his retribution.
Well, he shouldn't have murdered my bloody family.
Demanding retribution. This happened on Forrester land.
They killed my family.
And they'll pay for what they've done. That much, I promise. But now is not the time for vengeance.
If not now, when?
We have to be smart. Ramsay Snow will be here within the week.
And what would you have us do? Nothing.
I would have us use our heads while they're still attached to our shoulders.
Garrett has lost as much as anyone else within these walls. Maybe you can talk some sense into your uncle.
Garrett suffered enough already. You ask too much of the boy.
My uncle's right. We need to be smart.
Smart. Eddard Stark was smart. And look where that got him. So, what's to be done?
Ultimately, it will be for Lord Ethan to decide.
He's just a boy who can barely hold a sword. He knows nothing of how to lead men.
He is the lord of this house, and he needs our help. It's bad enough the Boltons would have us bend the knee and swear fealty. But now, this will accuse you of murder, and us of protecting you.
The boy was just defending himself.
I'm not faulting him for what he did.
It wasn't murder. It was justice.
Not in their eyes. It's just the excuse Ramsay Snow would need to put us to the torch and kill us all.
I'd like to see them try.
I'm afraid it's a risk we cannot take, which is why you cannot stay.
Cannot stay?
But where would I go?
The one place beyond the reach of even House Bolton.
You're sending him to the wall? The boy's done nothing wrong.
Not in the eyes of the Boltons. I'm afraid it's the only solution.
I'll do what's best for the house. So I'll go. I'm not afraid.
I know it doesn't seem fair, but it is what's best.
That settles it then.
You can have my horse, and I'll see you have plenty of food, but we haven't much time. The White Hills will come looking for you.
I know I was meant to say something to someone, and I keep forgetting who. I had the opportunity to say it a minute ago to the maester and his wife, but I wasn't meant to say it to two people. I was only meant to say it to one person, that's why I didn't say it. I'm hoping I get the opportunity in a minute, and
Hold
I remember.
I'd gladly drive a sword through Lord Whitehill's heart if given a chance.
Heart.
I would. And God's willing, someday I will. But for now, I have House Forrester to consider first.
Okay, lad.
Lord Forrester would be proud that you're putting the interests of the house ahead of your own.
Okay.
Many of Lord Forrester's best men have volunteered for the war.
I'll do what's best.
Which often isn't what's easiest, but necessary nonetheless.
I've been waiting for the right moment to tell you.
There we go.
What?
I knew...
Lord Forrester asked me to give you a message.
I knew I was waiting,
he
right?
Said, the North Grove can never be lost.
Sorry. You caught me by surprise. It's not often discussed, if ever.
He said tell only you.
For good reason. Most don't even know it exists. They think it's just a myth made up by wildlings and fools, and it's better kept that way. I assume you kept your word.
You
haven't told anyone else, have you?
Nay.
This is important, Garrett.
Of course not. I told no one.
Well done. Lord Forrester was right to put his trust in you. From this day forward, this will be our secret. But soon, I may need your help.
But
I can't say anything more just yet. Just know the North Grove may very well be vital to the future of this house. But don't breathe a word of it to anyone at the wall. Become a ranger if you can. It will help.
Curiouser and curiouser. What is the North Grove? Grove in the North, I guess.
Iron from ice.
Iron from ice.
Remember, you represent House Forrester. Your actions at the wall will reflect the honor and dignity of the house.
Ah, I pressed things. I did.
We will see each other again.
Iron for mice, lads.
Garrett,
iron.
Wait.
Oh, okay. Hello. Oh, that's nice. Did you make this for me? Little arts and crafts. Delightful.
Be safe.
Pretty sure that's the Minas Tirith tree. Just put this out there. Pretty sure it is. It looks exactly the same. It's a white tree. With no leaves, it's all spindly and stuff. I was under the illusion that this took place in the south. I'm trying to think, right, if this is the end of season 3, where is Tyrion at this point in time?
Ethan?
impish looking fellow.
Find him. Could you? He hides too well. And if he were smart, he would reveal himself.
I don't like this game anymore. Maybe something happened to him.
Ethan's fine. He's just forgotten this is a game.
You found me! Well done, Ryan. Don't worry. It's just a game, Ryan.
A stupid game. I don't like it.
He was worried you were gone.
I thought we'd never find you again.
I'm right here. And I promise, I'm not going anywhere.
I wish Mira was here. And Asher. And Roderick.
I do too. But Mira's in King's Landing and—
Can't she come home? I don't want her to die too.
Ryan, she's perfectly safe, I promise you.
I don't want Garrett to die either. Maester Ortengren said he got sent to the wall. I'll miss Garrett. He was nice.
He'll be fine. Garrett is smart.
No one will tell me what Garrett did, but it must have been serious. I heard Duncan and Sir Roiland talking. They said someone will come here looking for revenge.
Everyone's worried about you, but I'm not. I know you'll protect us.
Who said they're worried about me?
Well, Sir Roiland for one. He says you can't fight very well.
What?
And he calls you a milksop.
Well, with that hair.
Sir Roiland forgets himself.
I don't care what he says. I can protect you.
What does milksop mean?
I don't know. But I know it's not good.
Ethan, you should let Sir Roiland teach you how to wield a sword. Like a man. He taught Roderick and Asher, and he even showed me how to fight. Properly, I mean.
A lord should know how to fight.
Do you remember when we were younger? When we all used to play here? You, me, Roderick, Asher. We'd all be out here for hours.
Yeah. Where was I?
You weren't born yet.
We had so much fun. But then... Well, then everything changed. Roderick became so serious, the lord in training, and he never smiled anymore. And Asher just got angry at everything. Promise me you won't be like that. Please, just be you. I like you the way you are. I know a lord has many responsibilities, but you don't need to be like them.
I promise, I won't change.
Good. Because I'd rather have a brother than a lord.
You'll have to have both, I'm afraid.
But since you're the new lord, you can do anything you want.
I suppose.
I can fly.
Everyone will have to do as you say. So I could have all the sweets I want.
If only it were that simple.
That's not how it works.
Well, that's how it should work. You are the lord.
Kid's smart. Makes good points. What else is a king for, a lord for?
You're needed in the great hall at once. Quickly, on your feet.
Yes, sir. Come on, Ethan, you milksop. Which is now my favourite insult on the entire planet. Oh my god.
What's the matter?
Lord Whitehill has arrived, unannounced and certainly unexpected. He's come demanding justice.
Can't he meet with Duncan? He is the Castellan.
Stay with us. Please, Ethan.
He's demanding an audience with the Lord. We really must go.
It's your decision. You are the Lord.
Fine. If that's what's required of me.
Very well, then.
Doesn't have a trustworthy face, does he? This Roiland fella.
They showed up unannounced. Lord Whitehill is in a lather. I assume you explained to Lord Ethan why they're here?
A business with Garrett. I told him.
Lord Whitehill knows Garrett is a squire to this house. Or was, I suppose.
Is, was. It makes no difference. The Whitehills were clearly in the wrong, so don't give him any satisfaction. Out there, you were decisive and firm. Now do it again with these bastards.
Let's not do something rash. Things are bad enough as it is.
What should I say to him?
Tell him and his men to leave.
Now is not the time to anger Lord Whitehill any more than he already is. He's got 5 times as many men, and the backing of House Bolton.
All the more reason to stand up for ourselves. Only cowards and dead men roll over.
I have no idea what I'm going to do. Splendid. Positively splendid. Oh. Oh, you're a weird-looking man, aren't you?
Lord Ethan, is it? My condolences for your father and brother. The late Lord Forrester was no friend to me or my house, but to his family it's still a loss.
Yeah, as you told.
My only regret is I wasn't there to drive the dagger into his heart myself. I've been waiting for this day all my life.
My father died a hero, fighting for the North against traitors and oathbreakers.
Aye, and look where that got him.
He's one with the pigs
and
now.
No bread and salt! What kind of fucking house receives a lord with no fucking bread and salt? You bloody amateur. No courtesies. I should have expected as much.
Calm yourself, old man.
You little fuck! That's how you talk to a lord? You foresters have shit on us for generations. Well, now the Starks are no longer around to have your back, are they? We're the power in the North now.
Roose Bolton is the Warden of the North.
Aye. And we've been his bannermen for 5 fucking centuries, you cunt.
Whoa.
Lord Ethan, you're losing control of this.
That's enough, Lord Whitehill.
I'm not finished. Maybe if you hadn't been so fucking greedy with the Ironwood, things would have been different between us.
You squandered your share.
Our share was taken from us. We had no fucking choice but to harvest what was left.
What is it you want, Lord Whitehill?
Your man, the Squire. We were minding our own business, keeping the king's peace, as his lordship here said, when your man attacked us for no reason.
Hear that? Attacked for no reason.
No reason? You murdered his family.
Then you admit it was your man who killed my men. And a pig farmer at that. How do you answer for your squire, Lord Ethan? He acted in your name.
We lost people too, Lord Whitehill. Your men murdered his entire family.
You lost pig farmers, not soldiers. A soldier's worth 100 of their type. Where's the fucking coward who killed my men? I know he's here.
He was sent to the wall.
Who the fuck sent him to the wall? Answer me!
I did.
What? That was my justice to deliver, boy. And you denied me of it. I'm not leaving until I have my justice. Now bring me the coward who did it, or you'll answer to Roose Bolton. What kind of fucking house is this?
A house of honorable men.
Lady Forrester.
You bellow like a wounded boar, Lord Whitehill. Have you forgotten your manners?
I mean no disrespect to you, my lady, considering your losses and all. But this is not over.
It's over when my son says it is.
This is over, Lord Whitehill.
Ethan is Lord of Ironrath now. By rights, his word is law here. If that displeases you, then I trust you can find the door.
Well played, my dear. Well played.
That lad may be lord of this house, but Lord Bolton will have the final say.
Off you, Pop.
I'll send him a raven letting him know a Forrester man killed one of his own. That the new Lord Forrester lied to my face and denied me my justice. Then we'll see whose word is law.
Do as you like, Lord Whitehill.
Splendid time to end it. Thank you very much for joining me, ladies and gentlemen. It's heating up, isn't it? Didn't like this little Ethan fellow at first. Bit of a milksop. But he's got an interesting. Very cool. Cheers. Much love. Bye-bye.